Hello everyone, welcome back. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to replicate the fake 3D graphics from classic racing games.
You wanna race tonight?
To start, we are going to need a road texture. It can be any texture, but it's better if it's seamless, meaning if you place several in sequence, you won't notice where one ends and the next one begins. We will start by filling the screen with a blue tone, which will serve as the sky. After that, inside a loop, we will create subsurfaces from the road texture, each with only one pixel in height, which will be rendered on the screen one by one, from bottom to top, remembering to loop the index back to the start of the texture using the modulo operator. To create movement, I'm going to create a variable, carX, that controls how far the car has traveled, and then adjust the starting point so the animation moves in the correct direction. If everything worked, you now have a basic setup for a 2D racing game, but that's not why we are here. So now we are going to start adding the third dimension. The first thing is that as the road gets further from the camera, its apparent size decreases. We can try to achieve this by adjusting the scale of the subsurface based on the distance to the first slice. For now, we can use the loop increment as an approximation. Additionally, to keep the road centered, we need to adjust the horizontal coordinate. We also need to draw the ground next to the road, otherwise it looks like the road is floating on the sky. To do this, before rendering the road, I will draw a 1 pixel high rectangle where the color depends on the car X and the distance to the camera. Now we have something that starts to look 3D, but things don't seem quite right yet. We are still missing the sense of depth in the texture. The apparent speed of distant points should be slower than that of nearby points. To fix this, we need to apply the same scaling factor when selecting the slice of the road texture. Now, to make things more interesting, we can add a curve to simulate turns in the road. For consistency, this curve needs to be calculated based on the X coordinate of the car. To keep things simple, I use the sine function, with two wave amplitudes. This curve also needs to be multiplied by the scaling factor according to the distance. The same logic can be applied to the elevation, applying a staggered offset based on the distance. But here is where a problem arises. In regions with steep inclines, the rendered lines tend to spread apart, leaving gaps in between. Additionally, lower regions behind elevated areas are rendered on top, due to the bottom-to-top rendering order that was previously defined. To address these issues, I added logic to define the next line within a loop. First, I define a drawing distance that is gradually increased. Based on this, I calculate the values of X, scale, Z, and finally the vertical position. When the vertical position is smaller than the previous one, the loop is interrupted. After that, the rest of the logic is pretty similar. I just made some adjustments to the way the color of the floor is calculated, as well as adjusting the values of the scale parameters to get a nicer look. At this point, we have a scene with a winding road between hills, but it feels like the camera is flying above the road. Maybe this could be used for a flight simulator, but this is in fact a racing game. To fix this, we need to subtract the car's height when calculating Z, and subtract the car's horizontal position from Y. But where is the car? To make things easier, I will simply place a car sprite at the bottom center of the screen that doesn't move. Instead, the road beneath it moves side to side. Now we can create the car's controls. I created a very simple function that checks which keys are pressed to accelerate, brake, and change the car's direction. To control direction, I'm using an angle variable that's limited to 0.8 radians, or about 46 degrees, in either direction, since the car can't turn completely around due to the limitations of this technique. Now we can account for the effect of the car's angle when rendering the road, by multiplying the car's angle by the factor that depends on the distance on the screen to the car. Since the car is further ahead of the camera, I subtracted part of it so the first lines shift in the opposite direction. Since we now have the car rotating, I added a background that rotates along the car's orientation, shifting from side to side. Before moving on, I'm going to do a small code refactoring. At this point we can see some repetition when calculating y and z, for example, so I will put that into functions to ensure I will always calculate the same way. Additionally, I will put the logic for rendering the road slices into a function, as it will be used in the next step. So now to finish up, let's talk about sprites. Besides the car, we can have other cars on the road, as well as other items in the scene like trees or houses. To draw the cars, they need to be scaled the same way as the road slices, depending on its position. Since they are rendered after the road, I save the distance of the road slices into a sort of depth buffer so that the cars behind hills aren't rendered, resulting in horizontal and vertical coordinates on the screen. The only difference is that we need to subtract the car's height from the vertical coordinate. For static sprites like trees, the process is basically the same, except without the movement of the items. Now we have the foundation of a pseudo 3D racing game. Some things can still be improved, like unifying the sprites logic. Other things like game mechanics, collisions, will have to wait for another day. But that's it for this video, thanks for watching, and I see you next time.